So you want to make a directory in spec, okay, maybe called features. Okay, and then, so maybe the first thing that I want to do is I want to say that user can create to do, okay, spec.rb. Okay, so what I will do is, you always have to require, please ask question or stop me if I'm going too fast. So, okay, so now we are actually going to into writing test. Okay, so you will probably say something like feature, okay? User can create to do, okay? So this feature, and later on you will see scenario, you will see, okay, this thing. I don't know how to reply. Okay, so, yeah, so it doesn't really mean anything. It is just a message that prints up when you fail. So you want to write something that you can read so that you know what is going wrong, which test is going wrong, okay? So feature, user can create to do, okay? So maybe I give you a scenario that says successfully. So probably I imagine I want to, so this, now I'm going to write capybara syntax. Okay, so feature tests are basically tests that you imagine a user going through your site, what can he do. So now the feature that I want to write is that user can create a to-do. Okay, so what I, in my mind now, I probably say, first of all, I want him to visit the root path. Okay, so basically the default homepage. Okay, so after that, I want him to say, click on create a new to do. Okay, so there's a button there or a link there which says create a new to do. Okay, after that, I go to that page. I want to fill in, okay, the type a form, an input with title, okay, with maybe walk my dog. Okay, and then I want to say click on create to do. Okay, after that I expect, okay, so this is RSpec syntax. I expect this page, okay, dot to have CSS, okay, to have a certain HTML CSS element, to have CSS, say maybe you have a UL element, okay, an ordered list element that is to-dos, okay, and in there you have a list element, okay, and the text in it is walkadown, okay. So if we look at the feature as a whole, I want to go to the home page, I want to click create a new to-do, which probably brings me to another page, and then I'll fill in the input title with walkadown, and then I say create a to-do. Okay, and then after that is done, the page that I go to, I expect this page now to have a CSS, okay, with to boost LI, and it show me walk it up. Okay, yeah.
The click on,
yeah.
Must it be a link or a button or?
It doesn't matter. So it will find something with this wording and try to click on it.
Okay.
Okay, so now we want to make this thing work, okay? So this is what we want, okay? So probably we want to run the test now. Okay, so there are a few commands like rake. The default rake command will run tests, okay? Will run all your tests. So you will see that it's running the test at the moment. Okay, then you see that, oh, there is a failure, okay? So that's one failure, and the failure is user can create to do successfully. So user can create to do successfully. This is the error at the moment. Okay, so this place has an error and they say undefined local variable root path. So you see they are trying to walk through it, and then you can see that root path is unavailable. Okay, maybe I create my root path, then I go to routes, okay, maybe we get rid of all this. Then we say, okay, root 2, is it like that? Okay, so the new text is root. Maybe you want to go to your root page. For me now, I want to see all my to-dos, okay? So maybe it's my to-dos index page, okay? So now I have a root, but I run break again. you can see that now they say uninitialized constant to use controller. So I'm going to create this one. Controller. Inherits from application controller. Okay, so now I have this. If I run the test again, I'm gonna just run that specific file. Okay, if you have a newer computer, then probably it will be faster. Then you can see that, okay, now index. Yeah, that's why I'm gonna buy a new computer. That's my justification. Okay, so if you see, then they say here, okay, index cannot be found. Then you say create index. So if you know the flow, you could probably do more stuff before you run the test. But you always want to run the test to see that what you are doing is what you imagine it to be. So if I run now, they will probably tell me that I have a template, okay, that's missing to do index. So missing template, okay. So because I don't have the views yet, so let's create the views app.
The error is the same as what we saw, what we can see in the browser.
Sorry?
The errors. Is it the same?
Yeah, it is. It's from similar errors. Yeah. So you can use the browser also, but this one will automate your testing next time for all the things that you do. So you write it once, and then next time it will always help you. Okay. So, yeah. Okay, so I'm going to create a new. I'm also going to create index. Currently, I should be creating index. Okay, so in my index page, what should I have? Perhaps I have. Currently, what I need is a link. Okay, link to create a new to do. Okay, and it should go to our new to do path. Okay, so okay, let's try to do this. Okay, and if we run the aspect now, you will see that we don't have a new to do path. Okay, so what's a new to do path? So if you use the Rails normal routing, you can use resources and it will give you the default routes for the RESTful routes for to-dos, okay? So currently we need our, and normally you want to keep it specific to what you need. You don't want to just do resources to-dos. First, the reason number one is because you don't want there to be so many routes that your app has to go through if you run your app. The second one is your routes shows what your app can do. So if I'm another developer, maybe I want to run rig routes to see what your app can do. But if you have all these things which you're not using, then it's kind of difficult for me to figure out. Yeah. So then they say, oh, action not new cannot be found in the controller. So if I go to to-do's controller, I'm gonna go to new, and then we'll do more at this moment. So to-do, you know that you need to create an object for the forms. Okay, and in your views, okay, you need a new.html.yarv to lose new because the controller new will go to new. So here, I probably want a form, the to do, and so you probably want the label for its title, and you want the text field for the title, and then maybe you want a submit button, okay? And what this submit button should say would be create to do maybe. So if we look back at our spec test, okay, we say you should be able to fill in title and walk a dot and then create to do. Now I have the button create to do for you to click. Okay, so if I go on, and then this one will go to my user create action, okay? So I need create also, and earlier on I need index also, okay? So in create, if you guys have seen the default one, it will be something like that. First, you generate the to-do, passing in to-do param. So you will, even if that's one thing, for safety, like next time you want to add easily, you want to create a strong parameters to have to-do param. I like to indent my private so that it's obvious that that's private. This one depends. Not many people do it actually often. Params dot require to do dot permit title. Okay. So if it saves. Okay. Currently we will just save it. So there's no failure. There's no validation. There's no failure. Okay. After that we want to redirect to index or root path. Okay. Or to do's path like we call it. To do's path. This is the index path. Okay. So if we run it now. Oh, it seems like I have an error also. Uninitialized constant to do's controller to do. That means in to do's controller, you are trying to call to do, but it doesn't know what to do is. That is because I haven't created my migration and model yet. So I probably want to create my migration. Okay, so I want to create a to do. And I want to. No, I want to create to do, sorry. Create to do's. And then I want to pass in title. So you can pass in a column name here also. If it's a the default is a string, so I didn't pass in a string here. Okay, so if then it will generate the migration. Yeah, then you see it creates table to those T string title. Then you can break DB migrate. Then you can so you probably want to make a new model. To-do.rb. Okay, so class to-do which inherits from active record base. Okay, so now you have this. So let's run my test again. Okay, now they say I expected to find the CSS UL to-do's LI, but I didn't see it. Okay, but there were no matches. Okay, so this actually going through this is important for your test also because you will see like error messages like this. So you need to be able to read like the error messages, what's wrong with your thing. Okay, yeah, but what is add to do's? I haven't done add to do's yet, so I need it to be in my to do's controller in that section. Okay, it's equals to all my to do's. Okay, and now I run R spec. Okay, now it's passed the test, okay? If you want to be 100% sure, what you can do is you can just open up now your browser. And then you go to localhost. And you can see, okay, I have a quick new to-do. I can click in my thing and I can create to-do. Okay? And then you can see it, okay? So say you want to make a validation, you cannot enter empty to do. Okay, so first thing you do, you go to model, no, you go to your spec first, you go to your test first, you write your test first. Okay, so I come back here, user scenario, can create a to do, fails when no, when empty. Okay, I mean English can be improved like here, but. Okay, so I'm going to copy this because it's going to be quite similar. I want to go to the root path. Okay, I'm going to click create a new to do. I'll fill in title, blah blah blah, but I'm not going to fill in anything. Okay, I'm going to fill in empty. And then I hope that I expect the page to have maybe I want a flash message error. Okay, so I say to have a dot. Alert message, maybe an alert div that says to do cannot be false. Okay, so now I'm gonna run this. I'm gonna run the aspect and it should fail. Okay, so this is the first part, it should fail. One failure now for two examples. Now I'll need to get the test to pass. You want to test the part, you want to test that the you have to make sure that the test fails initially because you don't want to write a test that passed no matter what. So you need to make it fit such fail, then successful. So this is what we call red. So now it's red. You try to make it green, and then you refactor. So red, green, refactor. So refactor, you can improve the code. Okay, so now I'm going to add a validation, probably. Validate that title presence is true. Okay, so and then now we want to go to our to-do controller, and then we say if it saves, okay, maybe we don't do anything at the moment, but maybe we just redirect. Okay. Else. So then we want to say flash, or we just redirect to do path, but we pass the alert message behind. So this is another way to create a flash message. Alert, to do, and what we like. So you need to be exact. So, yeah, so sometimes this is a bug that we need to be able to see. So but I have a flash, but I need to display it. So normally if you want to display a flash, you would say here, maybe you will have seen different format, but I make a simple one at the moment. If alert, make a paragraph with a class of alert and put in whatever is the alert here. Okay, so if I go back to the feature test, I can, it's just a class, so I can add in a key or I can don't, then it will be a bit more flexible, I can change it next time. So if I run the test now, then you have two successes. So maybe I want to create a new to-do, and then I try empty, and then I express to-do, cannot be blank. So this test will always be available for you to run next time. Okay? So then you won't break your app without knowing. Okay, so now. Okay, so far, any questions? All good?
Instead of scenarios, what else is often used?
Nothing, it's just like that, just many features, many scenarios. So feature where a user can create to do successfully, fail when empty, maybe if you had more, okay? So say if you had your title is empty, and maybe you have more stuff, you have your body also, or your other text, okay? So you have title and text, then you want to check too, title empty also cannot, text empty also cannot, then you write another scenario. So many features, it's just words that, so that you can see it here, and each scenario separates from one text.
There's also things like describe and then
I'm
going to eat something. What's the difference between?
Okay, so, actually no difference. This one feature and scenario is for features. Describe and eat is for something as model test, controller test, you will see it later on. Except for walk-a-dog, you want to refactor it. Okay, so, so what you need to do is in support, okay, maybe you want to create a folder called feature. Features. And then you want to create a new file. So you call it like maybe create or todo.rb. So we have like our todo. We have our todo methods here. So you make a module. Okay, these are our helper methods called feature. And we want to say okay, so these two things is the same. We want to create to do, okay, with title. Okay, so we are just going to copy this and then we are going to change this to title. Yeah? So now we can just call create to do. So, you want to run the test again to make sure that you didn't break anything when you were refactoring, which I did. So, the reason I did is because I haven't included these things here. So, if you go to Rails Helper, you can see that you need to require the support, okay, all the files in support, which are config.rb. Okay? You also need to include them. You need to include the module feature for type feature. That means this will only run for feature tests. Is this the syntax? Let me check.
So
this, what does this do? Configure
feature is the module.
Yeah.
And type features is for the
R-spec. For the, so you will require this.
No method error to create CD.
In features.
Now we got it. Now the other one is, it doesn't see Walker Doc. Okay, so now we got it already. I didn't run my spec. Maybe didn't save a bit. Okay, so the reason is because, okay, I say Walker Doc here, this one is Walker Doc. Okay, so mistake. Okay, am I right? Fix our test. Okay, so now it passes. Okay, so, so we can refactor our test also. So next time whenever a create to do feature changes, maybe you have to click more things, then you can just change it here. Okay, and then it applies to everything. Okay, okay, so now maybe we want to go to creating. A user can register themselves, a user can sign up, a user can sign in and stuff. Okay, so then you can go into it and look into creating a new feature. Okay, so user can register. Spec. Oh, yeah, anyway, you need to name your file underscore spec so that you know to run this test. That this is a test. Okay, so as usual, you have to require your helper. Okay, and then you need to use feature. Maybe a user can register. Okay, and you will see very commonly we have, when we have a feature, we have successfully and probably unsuccessfully. Okay, so when probably we can visit our new registration path. Okay, and then we can see, if we go there, maybe we can see a form, okay? So we need to fill in with the, maybe email, okay? Fill in email. So if you notice it, fill in email, it can be a few things. So you can see that it locates a text field or text area and fill in with the given text, okay, the field. It can be found by name, ID, or label. Okay, so this is the locator. So yeah, fill in email with maybe person, okay, then you probably want to fill in like password with. Password confirmation, and then you want to click on sign up, and then you expect probably to expect teach to have I want to flash maybe text sign welcome. Okay, so we are going to run our test again, but not this one now. Spec, features, user, can register spec. Okay, so when you're writing, when you're testing, you probably want to run just the relevant file initially, so that because you're running all the spec will take some time. So okay, currently we failed. We don't have a registration path. Let's start with that. Okay, so when you're creating something like a registration controller, it's probably best if you create it as a resource, okay? So what's the difference between resource and resources, okay? So this to-dos, you can have many, okay? Resource is a singleton object, so you can only have one, okay? So how will you know if you have a singleton object? So you won't have any slash one. So like /1, you have /2, it has different objects. Okay, registration, you have one. Dashboard, you have one. Session, you have one. So all these are probably a single resource. Okay, so you want it single object. Yeah, okay, so resource, okay, we will probably need to have a form to see and also a create action. Okay, so now we have a new route. We probably need the controller. So normally, for me, my flow would be route controller view. So you need a whole flow. So we are gonna make a directory. We are gonna make a file in controllers called registration. So the weird thing about this is, even a singleton object, even though it's registration, the controller is plural. Okay, so I'm not sure of the whole logic behind, but that is how it is.
So registration controller, if you go to here, you can just copy up this line. Registrations controller. Okay, so you know you will need new. You know you will need create. Okay, so then we also need the views, of course. So So you need a folder, registrations. Okay, and then you need a new file called new. .html.arb. Okay, so okay, at this moment, if I'm gonna run my RSpec again, so let's see what error it gives me so that I know what I want to do next. Okay, visit. So unable to find auto load registration controller. Maybe because I deleted the file that I should have had. Mistakes were made. So if you use the browser, you also see this if you are more used to the browser, but if you start with this, then you can reuse it many times. Okay, so fill in, element not found, okay? Element cannot find email because I haven't done the new HTML.erb. So let's come here. And then we can see that I will need a form for, and I probably want to create a user object. Okay, so when I have a form for add user, okay, if it's a user object, where will it go to?
So it will go to users part. Okay, it will go to create slash. So in this case, I want it to go to registration. Okay, so I will need to pass in something different, URL, to go to our registration. Registration part. Okay, because I'm creating. So post will to be there. Okay, if you wanted to confirm, you can look at the red routes. Then you can see that registration. When you are posting to slash registration, you are using registration path. When you're going to a new one, new registration path. Okay? So, and then you need to pass the form object. And then you need to pass in f.label, probably the email. Okay? And then a text field.
How do you do your shortcut bracket thing?
Yeah, I installed a plugin called ERB Sublime plugin. So you can, it's a package. Okay, so we are going to copy this. Or you can use